Next, we have our public comments. Each speaker is allowed 3 minutes. Our first one is Donna Lay. We'd like for you to state your name and what part of the county you live in.
I'm Donna Lay, and I live at 208 East 12th Street, Washington. I still have questions about the jail, the new one, the need for it, the cost of it, not to mention its location. If the motive is to eventually move other functions to that site, be honest enough to tell the taxpaying citizens that. The planning process on that jail, in my opinion, has been inadequate. There's a lot of money to be made by the company who proposed this facility, and the taxpayer will be saddled with cost. We need a needs analysis done that is an objective, neutral determination of what we need that is not done by the company that stands to make a lot of money on the construction. This should include an analysis of case management in our current facility, including the use of home confinement, which needs to be adequately explored. And that notion that a judge can order a new jail is bogus. A judge can close a jail if the jail is found to be unsafe, if there is sufficient evidence available, and rightfully so. But it is a legislative function to determine how to correct the problems. Why couldn't the current jail be made adequate, at least until the economy picks up and some of our current bills are paid? I think it is unreasonable to raise the taxes that this will incur in the midst of the worst recession I have ever heard of. I can't remember when the country was in debt to the tune of $17 trillion before. Can you? $250,000 has been spent on renovations to the current jail. Beaufort County taxpayers are now being told that we will pay for another jail to be built, whether we like it or not, I suppose. Has there been a thorough analysis of the impact on the city of Washington as far as the location south of Chalkawinity is concerned? And also from whatever other functions you intend to use that 20-odd acres for? Above all else, the citizens who will be paying for this new jail should be allowed to determine how much debt is going to be incurred to solve the jail problem. We will have the ultimate say-so, one way or the other, so it would behoove you to allow us to vote on it up front. We deserve to hear you make your case to us and to sell us on your plan. It is clear to those of us who have observed your decision-making process that the discussions and debates that led to your votes took place behind closed doors out of public view. That is a violation of your duty to do the public's business in public where we can see and hear you, especially since we will be paying for this project for many years and we're already taxed to death. We have had too many backroom deals that have been that have cost the taxpayers out of this county entirely too much money. Finally, I would ask why the jail committee does not include any ordinary taxpayers. I, for one, think there should be an equal number of private citizens who represent the residential and commercial taxpayers of this county on that committee. In closing, I would advise you that a group of volunteer citizens is currently doing a study of our own on the jail issue. We will release this study to the media when it is complete, and we'll be glad to furnish it to you if you so desire. It's yours for the asking. Thank you.
Thank you. Ms. Kathy Vasquez.